Sometimes I'm building my power apps and I just want to test something that I'm not sure if it's going to work or if I'm going to apply to the app. So I don't want to keep doing in the very same app, because what if I need to return back to what I had before and I did a lot of changes? I just want to stay at that point and try the new things, and maybe if that works, I want to implement in the app. Today I'm gonna show how you can create a copy of your app so you can do that, while you keep your progress just at that point and avoid headaches. So let's take a look at my screen. For example here, I'm building this app for a course that I have in my own language, and I want to do some experiments before continuing this app, because I want to see exactly how I'm going to present the explanation to the students. In this case, I don't want to keep messing with the app here, I want to stop at this point, that is where the classes are. So I want to create a copy, and in order to do this, I just need to go here in this save icon, we have this arrow pointing down, and we have the save as button here. Once I click here, I can choose the name of the new app, that in this case is Agenda Power - Copy, because the original name is Agenda Power and it will suggest this name. For me it's okay, I'll click on save. Okay, if we wait a little, we are going to see that the Agenda Power here will change to Agenda Power - Copy. Right now it just changed, because now I'm editing the copy of my app. The original one that I just copied, it's there and it's safe. I can just change things here around and that won't be a problem. If I go to make.powerapps.com and go to apps, I can see now that I have two apps. One is the Agenda Power, the original version, and this one is the copy version that I'm editing just to test new things. Once I finish editing and I want to move back to the other app, I just need to click here and continue the edition of this app. Okay, so that's the tip that I use sometimes and it's very helpful. You don't need to keep doing this to create versions of your app, because once we publish, we can see the versions. So let's say you're editing, then you do a change, then you do another change and you publish, you can always return to the previous version without doing this. This is just in case I want to save a copy and that stays at that point and I can edit later, okay? If that tip was useful for you, please subscribe, leave a comment, and like the video. Bye bye.